In the previous class, we have discussed about the alphabets, what is the meaning of strings, what is the meaning of languages. We have already discussed. But in this class, we'll discuss about the substring. The first concept is the substring. What is the meaning of substring? Substring means consecutive sequence of symbols over the given string. Let's understand using the example. Suppose TOC is a string of length. TOC is a string of length is a 3. It is a 3 length string. So how many number of substrings will be generated using the given string TOC? The total number of substrings are equal to total. How? Epsilon is a substring. TOC, all are the total number of substrings. Epsilon is a substring of length 0. TOC, all three are substrings of length 1. TO and OC, both are substrings of length 2. TOC is a substring of length 1. So count the total number of substrings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total number of substrings here, 7. So now we can generalize the total number of substrings using N. Suppose if a string of length n, the total number of substrings equals to n into n plus 1 divided by 2 plus 1. These are the total number of substrings. For example, here TOC is a length of string. How much? Means in this case n equal to 3. Means for example, for TOC. TOC is a string. Means in this case n equal to 3. The total number of substrings equals to n into n plus means 3 into 3 plus 1 divided by 2 plus 1 means 3 into 4 divided by 2 plus 1 means 3 into 2 cancel 2 means 3 into 2 means 6. Means 3 into 2 means 6 plus 1 equal to means total number of substrings are 7. Now anyone can ask me, TC is a substring of the given string? No. But how? Here, what is the definition? The definition is consecutive sequence of symbols. Here, TO is a consecutive sequence of symbols. OC is a consecutive sequence of symbols. TC is not a consecutive sequence of symbols. So TC is not a substring. Okay, hope all of you understand. The next concept is how many K length substrings are there? How many K length substrings? What is the formula? The formula of K length substrings is equal to N minus K plus 1. For example, if TOC, if TOC, if TOC is a string, means in this case n equal to 3. So how many one length substrings are there? The one length substrings means TOC. These are called as the one length substring. One length substrings means here k value equal to 1. So means how many one length substrings? Means one length substrings are there. N means 3 minus 1 plus 1. 1 1 cancel equal to 3. How many two length substrings are there? In this case, n equal to 3 minus k value equal to 2 plus 1 means 2. 2 means TOOC. How many three length substrings are there? Three length substrings are there. That means n means 3. K value means 3 plus 1 means TOC. How many k length substrings are there? N minus k plus 1. Hope all of you understand about the substring. If any doubt, you can ask me through the comment box. The next concept is prefix of a string. Next concept is prefix of a string. What is the definition? Sequence of leading symbols over the sequence of leading symbols over the given string. For example, let's understand through the example. If TOC is a string, if TOC is a string, the total number of prefixes are here the sequence of leading symbols, that means epsilon T T T O then T O C then T O C. These are the total number of prefixes. Here sequence of leading symbols means T T O T O C. These are called as the leading symbols. So now we can also generalize the prefix of a substring. If a string of length n, then the total number of prefixes are n plus 1. So here, for example, TOC is a string of length 3. So the total of prefixes are 3 plus 1 means 4. Okay, hope all of you understand. So the next course concept is the total number of proper prefixes. Total number of proper prefixes are only n. The total number of proper prefixes are only n. Means this is by the total number of prefixes. So how many number of proper prefixes? So if TOC means TOC not include in the proper prefixes, means the total number of prefixes are here epsilon, T and TO. TOC is not a proper prefix. So the total number of proper prefixes, if a string of length n, the total number of proper prefixes are n. Okay, that's end your prefix of a string. Next we'll start the suffix of a string. Suffix of a string. What is the meaning of suffix of a string? That is the, this is the just the reverse of prefix. Means sequence of trailing symbols. Sequence of trailing symbols. Sequence of trailing symbols over the given string. For example, let's understand through the example. If TOC is a string, if TOC is a string, if TOC is a string, so the total number of suffixes are, total number of suffixes are epsilon C OC TOC. That means trailing symbols for C, then TOC, then TOC. Hope all of you understand. Leading symbols means this one, T, TO, TOC. But trailing symbols means from go through like this. This is called the total number of suffixes. Similarly, we can also generalize the total number of suffixes of a string. If a string of length n, the total number of total number of suffixes are n plus 1. It is just similar to total number of prefixes. Means if, for example, if TOC, its length is 3, the total number of suffixes are 3 plus 1 means 4. Similarly, the total number of, if a string of length n, the total number of proper prefix suffixes, proper suffixes are n. That means here epsilon C OC, but TOC is not epsilon C OC. The total number of proper suffixes are epsilon C OC. It is just similar to the total number of prefixes. Okay, that's the end of the suffix of a string, and also that's the end of our today's class. In the next class, we'll discuss about the what is the meaning of automata and finite automata, formal language, and like this. Okay, thank you.